From the JMA Dome in Syracuse, New York, ESFTV presents college basketball. Today, the ESF Mighty Oaks welcome the Onondaga Community College Lasers to Jim Boeheim Court. Hello again, everybody, and thank you for joining us on ESFTV for Mighty Oaks basketball. Cole Weintraub alongside Nico Horner. Horning, welcome. Welcome you inside the mecca of all of college basketball, the JMA Wireless Dome. And with the exception of 2020, this is the first time ESF is hosting their last regular season game since 2018 on this court, and it's really a unique experience for any team as OCC is playing their first ever game in the Dome. And Nico, this is really a great experience for two teams that are playing in just a great environment.
Well, that's what this game is all about today. Both teams haven't exactly had the best of seasons, but you come back here, and I'm sure a lot of these players grew up going to games here, going to Syracuse men's basketball games, and now that you get to come play on the home floor of Syracuse men's basketball is just an amazing experience. And both head coaches were saying beforehand that it's a matter of taking it all in. It's about having fun today while trying to play some true basketball. And of course, both these teams played against each other at the beginning of the season in November, which was a very high scoring affair, so both teams looking to change that again today.
They sure did, and it was Lamar Matthews, the sophomore guard from Buffalo, that led the way, 31 points for OCC. And Nico, he's really had a great season.
Lamar Matthews is definitely the leading scorer on OCC. He's done it really throughout the season, and he's definitely coming off one of his best performances recently against Clinton, where OCC won 79-73. He had a team-high 31 points in that one, and he just got named the third-team all-conference honor for the Lasers. So Lamar Matthews, look for him to try and get out hot today for sure.
Let's take a look at OCC's starting lineups. They'll run out Seth Miles at forward, Lamar Matthews, Anthony Brooks, Zach Chamberlain at forward, and William Scanlon. Let's take a look at Onondaga Community College as Joe Hulbert, the head coach, is in his first season at Onondaga Community College. Nico, we spoke to him before the game.
Yeah, we did, and he had some high things to say about his team, of course, but overall just really excited about this atmosphere today. He was also the team captain of Morrisville not too long ago.
Yeah, let's take a look at the ESF starting lineup. Christian Rossi at guard, Andrew Cox, Nate McCarthy, Patrick Emery, and Kieran Heffernan. And this is really Christian Rossi's last game as a Mighty Oak as we take a look at John D'Antoni, who's in his sixth season. But back to Rossi. He was one of the best three-point shooters on the team, leading the team in percentage. And, you know, this is a really great environment for him to finish off his career with the Oaks.
And Coach D'Antonio has mentioned Rossi as someone that's really brought toughness to this program. You know, he played at OCC before. He played on the other opposition of the floor today, but now he's playing for ESF, and he's been a culture changer for the Mighty Oaks, as Coach D'Antonio has described him.
He really has, and a key to the game for the Oaks before we get to the threes, you know, you got to get him open around the perimeter. You got to find the open man, and he's really been the one that has really let it fall all season long. For Onondaga Community College, they want to make off-ball cuts. That's what Hobart told us earlier before the game. That's what they got going in their last game. They want to run the transition offense. These are two teams that are very similar in play style, and they really want to handle Rossi and Emery.
That's what it's all going to be about, is who's going to step up and play defense. I think that's the most important takeaway from this game today. As you look at both these teams, they're very young, they're very fast. Who's going to play some defense and, you know, face guard some people?
And for ESF, they really want to have fun. In the JMA Wireless Dome in their final game, they want to keep Onondaga under 85 points. They've really struggled defensively this season, and they value the basketball. They really want to protect the basketball and not give away free points.
Protecting the basketball equals open shots, equals a lot of opportunities on the offensive end. And the Mighty Oaks have had some struggles taking care of the basketball this year, so they're hoping they can round out this game by doing just that, and they'll be just fine.
Sir? I mean, just take a look at this place. For two guys like us, getting into broadcasting for these guys playing their final game of the season. It's really just a thrilling experience being in the JMA Wireless Dome, the biggest venue in all of college basketball. It's unbelievable.
Well, you know what happened 24 hours ago? Jim Boeheim got celebrated yesterday. That's right. You know, knowing that happened right here on this very logo and this very court is really something special. Of course, former 47-year head coach for Syracuse men's basketball, Jim Boeheim. Now the court's named after him. And for these two teams to literally play on the court a day later is quite tremendous. And like I mentioned a few minutes ago, you know, a lot of people grew up coming to games here, and now they get to play their own game here. You can't beat it.
Let's lay off for the public address announcer. Really a special moment if you're Christian Rossi, you know, going from OCC to ESF, and as you said, really changing the culture for their basketball program. It's really cool to see this.
You know what's cool about Rossi? He won a state championship for OCC, or for rather for West Genesee in 2019 before going to OCC. Now he gets to finish up his, you know, collegiate basketball career at the JMA Wireless Dome, the largest college basketball environment and capacity. So very cool career for Christian Rossi to kind of round it out near his hometown.
Certainly, and it's got to be a dream come true for him and for OCC. These guys are 11-0 since 2011 against ESF.
Right.
I'm sure ESF and head coach John D'Antonio let us know that, you know, the team is aware of them being undefeated, and they have their number. And I'm curious to see how that plays a role in their really movement of the basketball today.
You look at stats, you look at historic records like that, and you can't get caught up in it because each year is different, each team is different every year. And the last couple of matchups between both these teams have been very entertaining and very close. I expect that again today, but you can't really look at the past, and I know both those teams aren't exactly kind of diving deep into that 11-0 record that OCC has favored in. But like I said, I mean, these two teams played each other in the very first game of the season, especially for OCC. They get to play their first game of the year against ESF. Now they come back to the Dome for the first time this season and end the season against ESF. And that first game was just a 9-point win for the Lasers, and the Mighty Oaks kept it close throughout the game. They led at halftime. So I expect another close battle between these two teams. But like I mentioned a few minutes ago, who's going to play defense? That's going to be the biggest question of today's contest.
Yeah, and in ESF's last outing against Villa Maria, they really struggled defensively down low against the big men. As I mentioned earlier, these two teams are very similar in play style. They're going to play fast. They're really going to move the basketball around. And it's transition offense that's really going to separate these two teams from one another.
Yeah, it's going to be very important. You know, both teams are fast, and especially the Lasers are a very fast team. They want to get up and down the floor. But we talked to Coach Holbert before the game, and he mentioned in that game against Clinton that was the first game he felt this year they played a full 40 minutes. They played a complete game. And if he can have most of that effort back today, I think OCC will be in a great spot.
Definitely. And if they can see shots falling early, I really think they can carry it out against ESF. But if you're ESF, you really got to get the ball in the hands of Patrick Emery, a guy who really, after a really fast first half, really slowed down last outing. So you want to get the ball in your best offensive player's hands at all times.
You know, it's funny, Cole. I don't think Emery gets as recognized as he should.
Sure.
He kind of gets undermined by Rossi, and rightfully so. I mean, Christian Rossi, the only senior on this ESF team, but now it's going to be Patrick Emery's turn, and he's just a sophomore, but he can do it down low. He's the leading point scorer for this team with nearly 21 points a game, the leading rebounder as well with close to 6 a game. He's coming off a team-high 26 points, and that was the matchup at Five Towns a couple weeks back. So Patrick Emery can do it all, and I think that ESF is tried to rely on him game in and game out as, you know, somewhat of a bigger guy on the team, even though it's a team that consists of all guards. We'll see how he steps up today because the Mighty Oaks are going to need him to get this contest.
They certainly are going to need him. And I really think it boils down to the off-ball screens. Getting Emery open, we saw him sink a couple three-pointers from the corner. Really designed plays, John D'Antonio talked about us last week. They designed some plays for Emery to get the ball in his hands, and I could really see something similar throughout the game today as he went quiet in the second half last weekend. So there are two teams that struggled this year, but they are two high-scoring teams. Talked about the defense. It's very important in a game like this, and you know this is a fast court. These two teams are going to move around quick. And who can get the last laugh in a game like this?
Look, to round out this whole spiel, it's two things. One is you're playing in the dome. Take it all in. And then two, it's like I've said it a couple of times, who is going to play defense? Because, again, both these teams had an offensive shootout last time out. Who's gonna try and guard some people?
Now, the starting center,
back here in the dome. The jump ball goes to OCC. Let's do it. Here in the JMA Wireless Dome. Move the ball around the perimeter, driving is Matthews. And Brooks steps out of bounds on the baseline. It'll be ESF basketball. Aussie up the court. Gets it back to Rossi. Rossi now stolen away from Matthews. Driving with the left hand. He'll go up with the dunk. 2 points for Matthews, and he gets going early. Emery drives with the right hand. This floater's no good. Rebound Chamberlain. Going the other way now. Kick it to the corner. Matthews driving with the right hand on the baseline. Brooks inside, back out to Chamberlain. Chamberlain spinning, driving with the right hand, and his shot is good. Really good right hand layup.
Talking about both of your leading scorers getting going early, and that's exactly what OCC wanted to do in this contest to start.
See the Mighty Oaks really spreading around the perimeter. As Rossi drives in hard with the left hand, and he's fouled on the way up, and he'll go to the line for two.
That's what the Mighty Oaks have struggled with a lot this season, is they kind of get comfortable with shooting from beyond the arc, and then when they miss, it comes back and haunts them. So for Rossi to try and get going to the hoop early on, which is something that he's been known to do, that'll put ESF in a good spot the rest of the way.
Rossi on the year, a 73.5% free throw shooter, as his first shot was good. And as you mentioned, as ESF has fallen behind to some pretty sizable leads this season, they really need to, you know, get inside and make things happen. Rossi's second attempt is no good, and it's rebounded by Brooks. Driving is Miles with the left hand. It's no good. And Rossi grabs the rebound. See the transition offense from the Mighty Oaks as Emery gets baseline, drives in home. Patrick Emery, their leading scorer, gets on the board. As OCC comes down, Matthews' dunk attempt is no good. Pass down the court to Emery. His floater's no good. Gets his own rebound, and he's fouled on the way back up.
Well, going back to the other side of the floor, if you're Matthews, you got to make that dunk. I mean, either lay it in or make the dunk. There's no excuses for that not going in. So that's number one. And then for ESF, credit to them getting back in transition and trying to make something happen at the rim with Emery going to the line for a couple of shots.
Emery's first shot is no good. He shoots 82.5 from the line on the year, averaging 20.5 points per game. Second shot's good. Ties it up here at the dome. It's Brooks, their main facilitator, with the ball at the top of the key. Swinging it around the perimeter. OCC looking for a basket. Brooks out to Matthews. Good ball movement by OCC as Chamberlain drives with the light right left hand. No good. Rebound Cox. A strong rebound by Cox. And the Mighty Oaks looking for their first lead.
Yeah, Cox averages nearly three rebounds a game and got a big one right there inside the paint.
Drives in hard with the right hand. No good. Rebound OCC. And we're going the other way. Okay, Brooks going in with the right hand, no good. Emery grabs the rebound.
You can tell, Cole, that OCC really wants to get out in transition.
As rebounded by McCarthy. His putback is good. Like you mentioned, these are two very fast teams. OCC and ESF's identity is really playing the fast-paced offense, getting out in front and making noise. Swinging around. Three-pointer's good. Will Scanlon from downtown. The sophomore from Rochester. Emery, turnaround, back outside to Cox. His three-pointer, no good, short, rebounded by McCarthy. Reset by the Mighty Oaks. Franco Aguado thinks about a three. Rossi will take it. Rebound again by McCarthy. Franco, step back three, no good. And it's rebounded by OCC. Going the other way now. That's Miles. Coast to coast, and he's fouled. Jump ball going in possession with the Mighty Oaks.
A couple of crazy sequences lately, but that's what I've talked about with the Mighty Oaks, getting a little too comfortable from downtown. They luckily got a couple of offensive rebounds for another crack at a three-pointer, but you can't live by that. And you got to go to the hoop and try and knock down a couple of more free throws, which they've already missed.
Rossi thought about a three, kicks it back out to Franco. His three-pointer from the corner is no good. Put back by Emery is no good, and it's OCC possession. Coast to coast, Miles is fouled on his layup attempt, and he'll go to the line for two.
Well, that's what Seth Miles can do. He can really turn on his speed at any moment, and even though he's a forward on this team, he's very versatile and can drive to the hoop when you need him to. Scored 14 points last time out against ESF, and he's already knocked down a free throw today for his first points of the game.
Efferin checks in for Cox, and to your point, 14 points last game. He paired that up with 10 rebounds, 6 assists, 3 steals in their win at Clinton Community College. Miles' second shot is good.
Yeah, the thing about Miles, he's a very consistent player. He might be one of the most consistent players on the Lasers, so look for the Lasers to go to him when they need a clutch mid-range shot or something down low in the paint.
Pretty spin move by Emery. His shot's no good. And look at OCC pushing the ball up the court. Brooks goes in hard, no good. Rebound Rossi. Both teams are really not finishing out the rim today.
Well,
so far.
Yeah, the Lasers are really known for trying to get out in transition and create something at the hoop, but ESF, credit to them, has done a nice job offensively protecting that.
Franco back out to Emery, three-pointers no good. Strong rebound by Chamberlain. These two teams playing fast, as we mentioned early. Chamberlain to the rim, it's good. Five-point lead, 15 to go. Rossi's mid-range shot from the line, no good. Rebound OCC, pushing it back up. Matthews to the baseline, kicks it to the corner. Chamberlain's three-pointer off the front rim. Rebound Franco. Rossi comes in from transition. Fakes his layup, goes back up, and puts it in.
Great finish right there. You saw Miles get a piece of that basketball, but Rossi stuck with it.
And OCC comes right back down as Chamberlain lays one in. There's that transition offense. It is relentless, Nico.
It is, and Zachary Chamberlain, another guy that kind of gets overlooked from OCC thanks to Lamar Matthews. The second leading scorer on this team is Chamberlain.
Emery, a strong finish. And the timeout is called by Onondaga Community College. A three-point game here with 14 to go. Good for ESF. Emery getting back on the board after a couple misses down low. And I would like to see him get going. You know, he's easily one of the biggest guys on the court, and he could really, you know, make a difference down low and win that game inside.
Well, he's got a game-high 5 points so far, and he, you know, obviously he does lead the team in points, and I think he's showing his athleticism today so far by driving to the hoop. And he's someone that, he's an 82% free throw shooter, but he's already, you know, missed one so far, so expect him to just get more comfortable here throughout the game. And if you think about it, shooting a free throw in this place is a lot different than shooting it in a smaller gymnasium. So
that's for sure.
A little more pressure just because of the environment that you're in, and, you know, you got a lot of family and friends here today to watch you, so it's going to take a minute for these players to settle in.
Certainly. Back out of the timeout. Armstrong checks in for OCC. He had 23 last game off the bench on 8 of 10 shooting. Scanlon inside. Back out. Brooks three-pointer. No good. Off the front iron. A strong and fast rebound by Nate McCarthy. He's pushing it down the court. And up with McCarthy after a Franco miss. A nice putback by Nate McCarthy.
Clean up on aisle three by McCarthy. Really just a great finish right there. We've seen that a couple of times with ESF.
Scanlon's fouled on a three-point attempt. And he'll go to the line for three.
Well, you never want to foul a three-point shooter. I think everyone can agree on that. But it's going to come down to the free throw line for Scanlon, a 71% free throw shooter this season. And you know, it kind of goes to describe the way that both teams want to play. It's a fast brand of basketball, and with that, you're going to have fouls, whether it's driving to the hoop, whether it's closing out on guys too fast and really getting yourself into a rut with fouling three-point shooters. So with a faster pace of basketball, there's a lot more fouls that come with it.
Salerno and Cox. Cox is back in as Emery and Franco take a seat. Scanlon's second attempt is good. 4-point game, 16-12. OCC over ESF. Just about 13 to play here in the first half. Heffern on the baseline. Cox with it now. Quick pass to McCarthy. Cox from downtown, no good, off the front iron. A lot of these shots are short thus far, Nico. See if Chamberlain can execute. No good. Off iron. Rebound Salerno.
Well, that's what we've seen ESF kind of result in with their shots, is they just come up short a lot, especially from downtown, just not exactly getting the movement that they want.
One more from Heffern in the corner. No good. And it'll be OCC basketball.
That possession right there for the Mighty Oaks is one that I think Coach D'Antonio will be happy about. You saw the ball movement. They found an open shooter at the far corner. Just didn't knock it down, but a very well-executed possession right there, and one that looks smooth overall offensively.
Try to get the ball into the hands of Rossi, their best three-point shooter, as Matthews takes a three, and it's good. OCC's leading scorer from behind the arc. 7-point game now. Mighty Oaks, you'd love a basket here. Rossi drives with the left hand. He's fouled on the way up. Shot's no good, but he'll go to the line for two free ones.
Well, going back to that Lamar Matthews three-pointer, I mean, he killed ESF at the beginning of the season from downtown. Made 5 of 8 three-pointers. So Matthews is going to try and get lethal again from downtown when he can. And with Christian Rossi at the line, that's going to struggle for the Mighty Oaks to start this game, is just missed opportunities at the free throw line. You got to capitalize on that.
You sure do. And when you're searching for your identity, you're getting to the rim, you're getting fouled. You have to hit those free throws, especially if your three-point shots are not falling, which has been the case so far for the Mighty Oaks.
And you talk about searching for your identity. It's not really a theme you want to have going on late in the season, especially in your very last game of the year. But what Coach D'Antonio wants the Mighty Oaks to take out of this game is to, you know, try and get, well, both coaches really, try and get prepared for next year with this game. Who's going to have the momentum going into the offseason, especially with two fairly poor seasons from both sides?
Pretty pass by Brooks inside to Armstrong. He stepped on the baseline. It'll be Mighty Oaks basketball. We look at Brooks averaging 6.4 assists per game. He's second in the conference in assist to turnover ratio at 3.3, so easily their best facilitator. Cox behind the back dribble, kicks it to the baseline. That's Heffern driving in. Looking for an outlet. That's Emery. 5 to shoot now. Emery, pull-up jumper is good. A huge shot from Patrick Emery to bring the lead within 4. Boy, did the Mighty Oaks need that.
That's what you expect from your leading scorer with Patrick Emery, is the ability to create an open space, especially with the shot clock winding down. He did that right there.
Scanlon drives. His layup is no good. Heffern gains possession, kicks it to the corner. Emery's three-pointer is good. Back-to-back possessions, back-to-back sinks from the Mighty Oaks leading scorer, Patrick Emery. 1 point game now.
Emery's already in double digits today, just a really hot shooter from downtown and really anywhere on the floor, and grabs a rebound right there. Patrick Emery, the star on this ESF team so far today.
If he gets in the zone, he could be a problem as he gets fouled on a shot attempt right around the free throw line, and he'll go to the line for two, and could see three straight possessions, three straight points on the board from Emery.
Just a really versatile player, and I don't think it can be talked about enough, because I brought up Christian Rossi, but Patrick Emery, he's your guy, and when you need a basket, you go to him, and I think ESF has really turned to him in the last couple of possessions to try and create and knock down some shots, and now they're back in this game because of Patrick Emery.
Emery looking for the Mighty Oaks' first lead. It's good.
What ESF has really done in the last couple of minutes is just calm itself down. I mean, the first couple of minutes, Colt, we couldn't even talk to each other because these teams were playing so fast.
Right.
But now you have some more sets on each side, especially offensively, and both teams are trying to find their groove, and I think they've done so in the last few minutes.
Pagan checks in for the Lasers. McCarthy inside. Salerno has it now. Emery, nice pass to McCarthy inside, and he's fouled.
Great feed from Emery, slithered it right there at the right block. And, you know, that's what he can do. I mean, obviously, this guy can score the basketball, but he can also pass it as well. Just a great feed right there, and chance for a couple of more points for the Mighty Oaks.
McCarthy's first shot is good. If you're Emery, you've got two more years of eligibility. You're already the team's leading scorer. A super bright future ahead for number 25. Kielman checks in, puts up a three, no good. Was looking for a foul. Salerno, last one to touch that one. It'll stay down here with the Lasers. Matthews to inbound. Tie game here in the dome. Pagan, three-pointer. No good, off the front iron. Rebound by Emery. See if Emery take control of this possession once again. He's inside with it, driving with the right hand. Foul is not called as Brooks pushes it down for the Lasers. Brooks gets inside and puts it in.
Great move by the shifty Brooks, but on the other side, credit to Noah Armstrong for just keeping both arms up and getting the ball out of Emery's hands in the paint and allowed for those 2 points for OCC.
Really good baseline movement by the Mighty Oaks as McCarthy puts it home. Up and under layup by Brooks. Really starting to see these teams really trying to get the ball on the baseline because they think that they can win by doing so with the lack of size down low. Emery inside. Hook is no good. Gets his own rebound. Goes up with it. Fouled and one. Patrick Emery is having a first half here in the JMA Wireless Dome.
What a move by Patrick Emery. Drew the foul. Obviously has the toughness to stay with it. Punch it in the red circle there, and he's going back to the free throw line. Patrick Emery been very impressive to start this game, Cole. He's also a local kid, went to Fayetteville Manlius High School, so he's got some support in the crowd today. He's all amped up.
You can already tell he's starting to feel it. Just a different attitude than what we saw at Villa Maria. As Pagan's three-pointer is once again no good. Brooks back inside, a pretty pass to Miles as he goes up and under and he puts it in. Really nice pass down low by Anthony Brooks.
Yeah, and a soft roll off the glass as well for that one to spin in.
Steal by the Lasers. Pass down low to Pagan. It's stolen away by Rossi now. Rossi going to the other end. Kicks it to the corner. Emery's shot is no good. But it'll stay down here with the Mighty Oaks.
Beat check.
Yeah, seriously. Rossi to inbound. Franco from downtown, no good. Rossi tries to keep it in, but Miles is right there to snare it. Kicks it to the corner. That's Keelman off the side of the backboard. Rebound by Armstrong. A strong finish from the guard from Portland.
Armstrong coming off a team-high 23-point performance in Clinton last Sunday, and he's had a slow start to this game, but trying to find his groove, and a great finish right there.
Franco's fouled on the way in.
Well, this is what happens with the Mighty Oaks. This has been kind of a reoccurrence this season, is they'll get back into the game. You know, they'll go down, let's say, 8 points. Someone gets them back in, which in this case it's been Patrick Emery, and then they'll sort of start to get careless with the basketball, and that's going to be the most important thing for them throughout the rest of the game. Is obviously basketball is a game of runs, but how do you manage those post runs for ESF? And I thought they've handled it pretty well so far.
I would tend to agree. If they ever get a lead, they really have to concern themselves on closing it out. They had a really sizable lead early at OCC against Villa Maria last weekend. Just gave it right away with turnovers. Protecting the basketball has become so important for them all season long. As Miles goes up with a dunk, it's no good. Cross-court pass to McCarthy. Gets it back out to Rossi now. Rossi driving in, goes up and under. Rebound McCarthy, and he's fouled on the way up. Strong effort by Nate McCarthy to keep the possession with the Mighty Oaks.
And Andrew Cox on the other end, I think might have gotten a piece of that basketball. So ESF, defense great and offense. That's what we said at the top of the broadcast. Who's going to play some defense today? And, well, both sides are playing some defense so far. I thought ESF has done a great job so far in this game.
I do like this timeout called by Coach D'Antonio. Down a basket. You're back on the free throw line once again. You take the lead. You hit both. It's really refreshing to see ESF getting off to a good start offensively. We knew that would be the story here with both teams struggling defensively all season long. But it's, like I said, who can come out with that last laugh? Got to make a statement going into halftime.
Yeah, it's going to be important who can close out these last 6.5 minutes of the game, as you just got a shot of the ESF students here, and they are just having a great old time here at the JMA Wireless Dome. Of course, the campus right across the street behind us. And, or I should say to our left. You know, it's very interesting how this court is kind of turned around on your picture there on the screen. To that right side where those empty seats are, the football field basically plays perpendicular to the basketball court. So it's a very interesting layout here in the dome, but a very cool experience nonetheless.
And for these fans, the opportunity to sit down on the floor, well, that could be once in a lifetime for some that might not be able to come out to too many Syracuse games. Being on the floor in the dome is a great experience, as McCarthy's first shot is good. 6:31 to play here in the first half. McCarthy misses the second. OCC looking to get back on the board, as it's Miles now. Driving inside hard is Brooks, and he's fouled. You can tell Anthony Brooks is really the motor in this Lasers offense. He really controls the ball, and if Matthews isn't on the court, he's certainly their primary ball controller.
Well, Lamar Matthews got the third-team all-conference honor. Burks is an honorable mention. And, again, he's kind of one of those smaller guards that just gets a little overshadowed, but his ball control is really efficient throughout the court. And he's done some nice effort so far getting to the free throw line, but couldn't knock him down right there.
This place is getting loud, Nico. Franco, a pretty crossover, goes in with the right hand. His layup is no good. Strong rebound by Chamberlain, pushing it down court. As Armstrong goes up with the left hand and puts it home.
Armstrong starting to heat up a little bit. Like I said, had the team high in points last time out. And he's doing a nice job of driving down the lanes, trying to create some offensive baskets there.
And these transition passes are consistent by OCC. There's a few steals. Lands in the hands of OCC. Chamberlain drives with the left hand, is no good. Rebound Brooks, he goes up with it and puts it in.
Bit of a careless basketball from both sides there, but OCC finally calms it down. And of course, the basketball finds itself in the hands of Brooks again. Again, who's going to close out these last 5 minutes of halftime? It's going to be very important.
Rossi is fouled.
We go back to that game at the beginning of the season, and OCC won by 9, but ESF had the lead at halftime, and we'll see what can come out of these last few minutes. They led 59-53 at halftime last time out, and obviously, you look at the point differential between that game and this game.
Right.
I mean, that's you're saying, you know, 15, 20 more points from now, and there's still 5 minutes to play, so they're going to obviously get up there. But you talk about how both offenses were rolling last time out. I think both have decided that defense is going to be the move today.
That's right. Very few times do you see 220-plus points put up in a collegiate basketball game. This Rossi hits the second free throw. .510 to play here in the first half. The JMA Wireless Dome in the final regular season game for the ESF Mighty Oaks and the Onondaga Community College Blazers. As Chamberlain's layup is good, and it's a 4-point ball game. Heffernan and Salerno check in for the Mighty Oaks. Rossi's three-pointer, no good. Chamberlain's awarded the rebound there as Matthews pushes it down the floor. Pull-up jumper from the line, no good. No trading misses as Rossi drives in left hand. Gets it outside to Emery, who checked back in just before. Shot no good. And ESF yet another offensive rebound. Rossi. Heffernan for three. No good. Rebound Salerno. Back inside to McCarthy. Another offensive rebound. He goes up with it again and puts it in.
How about those offensive rebounds for the Mighty Oaks? And despite that, I mean, they're still having trouble finishing at the rim, but finally they got one to go right there. A great ball movement overall from the Mighty Oaks.
This could be something that we talk about for the rest of the game. It's really these offensive rebounds and the second chance points. Armstrong, hop step, kick it out to the corner. Chamberlain with it now, drives in hard, and he's fouled. Chamberlain, a 56% free throw shooter, will get two from the charity stripe.
First, but another, you know, local product, Oswego High School, the other honorable mention on these Blazers team. So you have Lamar Matthews as the third team all-conference honor. You had Anthony Brooks as an honorable mention, and so was Zachary Chamberlain. So kind of the three-headed monster for the Blazers so far this season, and I think ESF has done a decent job of containing all three of them so far today.
And where he drives in hard, he's fouled once again.
We saw Matthews be so efficient in the first few minutes of this first half, but I think the Mighty Oaks have obviously realized he's the best player on the team, but they've done a nice job containing him in the second half of this first half.
Yeah, Emery has certainly stolen the spotlight, making his name known as he hits the first.
Yeah, it's a good point. I mean, you had Matthews get out hot. He knocked down a triple, had a couple of other baskets, and then all of a sudden Patrick Emery emerged for the Mighty Oaks when they were down 8 points, and he's allowed them to come back in this ball game despite missing a couple of free throws. Another offensive rebound for the Oaks.
Something else. As Rossi with it at the top of the key. With 3:12 to play, Heffron from the corner, his three-pointer is good. A big shot by Heffron. Gives the Mighty Oaks a one-point lead now. Lamar Matthews from three is no good. Rebound OCC. Back outside to Armstrong. Kick it to the corner. That's Chamberlain. Three-pointer is no good. Strong rebound by Emery. Has it stolen away by Miles, but then stolen again by Heffron. Chaos at the end of this first half. Rossi. Foul. He'll go back to the free throw line.
Zachary Chamberlain picks up the foul there. He's a little frustrated, but it was the right call. Kind of had a, not over the back, but definitely reached his arm over the shoulder of Christian Rossi.
That's OCC's 10th personal foul of the half. So ESF in the double bonus.
We got Chamberlain talking to Coach Holbert on the far side, and just another teachable moment from Coach Holbert. He's a young guy himself. I mean, he didn't play that long ago, assistant at SUNY Morrisville for the last few years, but he also was the team captain of Morrisville, and in his first season as head coach for this OCC team.
Just about 2 minutes to play. See who can really close out the first half strong. Miles a three-pointer. He connects. OCC back out in front.
Miles just a 24% three-point shooter, but when he makes the baskets from outside, he's very effective.
Rossi sizing up. Brooks goes up. No good. Rebound Salerno when he puts it in as he flexes the muscles.
Well, this ESF team is feeling it. I mean, this is some of the most energy they've had all season, and you'd love to see in the last game of the year.
Miles takes another three-pointer from the same location. Once again, no good. Rossi coming down the other way now. Driving it hard. Baseline pass to McCarthy in this area.
Oh, what a great feed to McCarthy on the baseline. The ESF is really, it passed the basketball very well today. I think that's been a difference maker on the offensive end. And seems like everything is going right for them so far, pretty much since the first few minutes of this contest.
With yet another personal foul, Kieran Heffron will go to the free throw line. ESF now up five, looking for two more. This shot's no good. Heffron, a 66% free throw shooter from the line.
Heffron's been effective today, just doing the small things. You know, he had two rebounds at Five Towns a couple of weeks ago. But he's kind of one of those scrappy guys for the Mighty Oaks, and I think he's been effective. You know, he doesn't fill the stat sheet a whole lot, but when he comes in, he gets some valuable minutes as Coach D'Antonio gives him a nice big high five there on the sideline.
The Mighty Oaks retained possession after the Lasers knocked prospective rebound out of bounds as Cox drives in. No good.
Well, first of all, Rossi had an errant pass there from the baseline. And he kind of lofted it in the air. Not exactly sure what was going on. And boy, does OCC respond the other way. A much-needed triple for the Lakers.
As you said, Scanlon, a big three-pointer. Three-pointer from Franco, and he answers. Going back and forth here in the JMA Wireless Dome. To play here in the first half. Pass, Aaron pass out of bounds. A turnover by Scanlon.
OCC has just gotten a little careless with the basketball as of late, but credit to the defense from ESF. Going back to that Antonio Franco three-pointer, he had a 2-for-10 three-point performance a couple weeks back at Five Towns, and he's responded so far. Can he do it again?
In and out. The Lasers will push it down the court with 1 second. It's no good. A half-court attempt by Anthony Brooks. The Mighty Oaks with a strong ending to the first half as they take a 46-42 lead. We're watching college basketball on ESFTV. Mighty Oaks lead it by 4, going into the second half.
Welcome back to the JMA Wireless Dome at halftime. ESF has a 46-42 lead over the Onondaga Lasers. A very close battle so far in this game, much different than what we saw at the top of the season when both these teams were in the 50s at halftime, a very offensive-minded game. We've seen some defense today as we get a look at our halftime stats so far, and pretty equal across the board. OCC has had 11 fouls compared to ESF's 4 fouls, but the Mighty Oaks have done a nice job of driving to the hoop and OCC having to foul down there. And as far as the rebounds go, pretty consistent as well on both sides, 21 for ESF and 18 for OCC. A nearly 45% field goal mark from both sides. And that is your halftime stats so far. ESF 46, Onondaga 42. Hey, stick with us. We'll have a couple of guests coming up here from the national championship cross-country team for ESF. They'll be back with us on the other side. We'll step aside. You're listening to College Basketball on ESFTV. Back here inside the JMA Wireless Dome, ESF Mighty Oaks lead the Onondaga Lasers 46-42 here at halftime. But stepping away from the game for a moment, we have a special of a couple guests here from the cross-country national championship game. I'm Nico Horning, joined by Aubriana Brown and Sean Driscoll, both of you members from the ESF cross-country national championship team. First of all, Aubriana, I'll start with you. What was that experience like in November?
It was really intense, honestly. We had done so much preparation to get there, and there was a lot of pressure on us to win for a third year in a row. We were very excited to get back out, and we felt very strong going in. So, yeah, I was very confident in our preparation for that meet.
And, Sean, for you, what did that preparation consist of going into Pittsburgh?
Just consistent training, making sure, like, a lot of the guys' team were dealing with some injuries, like our on our top five, so we're just trying to keep healthy so we can be full strength during our national championship.
And for going to compete in an event like that, especially going to Pittsburgh, going on the road and traveling a little bit, what was that overall experience like for you guys just to kind of explore a little bit outside of just being on the track during cross country?
Yeah, well, we're really lucky in that in the 4 years that we've been doing this, we've gone to so many cool places. I've run on tracks that some of my, like, idols, like professional runners, have run on. So it's a really cool thing to be a part of.
Very
exciting, yeah.
And for you, Sean?
All the trips that we go on is, you know, just really gets the team closer together and just some more time to spend and just prepare for our races.
And this is a great concept for, obviously winning a national championship for cross country is something in its own. But for those of you that may not know a lot about, you know, the different types of runs that go on or anything like that, what is your guys' kind of specialty going into cross country?
Right, yeah. So the women run 6Ks, which is just about 3.5 miles. And the men run?
We run 8Ks, which is just under 5 miles.
That's awesome. Yeah. And what was the timing like? What was the results like for you guys this year to be able to come out of that national championship with a win?
You want to know my time that I
ran? I'd love to hear it.
I honestly, 24 minutes,
wow.
Something like that.
Wow.
Okay, I came in fourth on the team overall, so there were some girls on the team that were faster than me. So.
So you said three and a half miles?
Yeah, just about that.
24 minutes. That's pretty fast.
Thank you.
Folks, Aubriana Brown is a very fast racer over here for cross country. And for you guys, just real quick, you know, what can you take away from these 4 years, especially wrapping it up with another national championship?
I would say just take away all the friends you make on the team and all the hard work that you put in, you know, whether that be waking up at 6 o'clock on a Wednesday before school to do a workout or, you know, waking up on Sunday mornings do, you know, 12, 14 miles for our long runs on Sundays. So.
That's awesome. Well, guys, keep up the great work. Congratulations once again on the ESF National Championship for cross country, and enjoy the rest of the game.
Thank you very much.
All right, that was Aubriana Brown and Sean Dristol here joining us at halftime on ESF TV. The Mighty Oaks lead the Lasers 46-42. We'll have second half action on the other side. You're watching college basketball on ESF TV. Back here inside the JMA Wireless Dome, the Mighty Oaks lead the Lasers 46-42, and a very entertaining first half as we bring you back in here at Jim Boeheim Court. Nico Horning alongside Cole Weintraub, and Cole, a very entertaining first half, much different than what we saw at the beginning of the season between these two teams, a very high-scoring offensive game in that one, this time a little bit more defense.
little bit more defense, a little bit more free throw shooting, as ESF has really tried hard to get to the basket, really try to execute down low, and it's really the baseline movement that they've really been able to capitalize on. Really, Nate McCarthy, Patrick Emery, they really had strong first halves, and we look for that in the second.
Yeah, it took a minute for Emery to heat up, and especially with Lamar Matthews kind of getting hot early on for OCC. What do you expect from those two, obviously the stars of each team, to try and produce on here in the second half and build off of their first half performance?
Well, I thought Lamar Matthews got off to a really strong beginning, and then he kind of faded as the first half went on. I could really start to see him, you know, getting back out in space, really trying to find his own shot and make something happen for the Lasers.
Well, it should be a very entertaining second half here. Happy to have you with us here on ESFTV with 20 more minutes of basketball to go here in the 2023-24 season, as it'll be OCC to inbound the basketball to start this second half. A half where ESF also led in the last game. They led 59-53, and now they're up by four as we begin the second half of play. See how the Lakers can respond and get going offensively. And it's going to start with this guy, Lamar Matthews, with the bright yellow shoes. See how he gets going to start this second half. But a spin around Jay, too strong by Zachary Chamberlain, and the Mighty Oaks go out in transition. Here's a three ball by Franco, too short. Another offensive rebound for ESF, and Rossi steps into one too strong. That's been a consistent theme throughout this game, is the Mighty Oaks trying to fight for those offensive rebounds, Cole.
I gotta say, Nate McCarthy has really just put in great effort all day long, really not giving up on the possession. You know, a shot might miss, but he's right there to try to grab the offensive board.
Well, his offensive rebounds have proven worthy for ESF, keeping them in a lot of possessions. Of that little up-and-up shot is good by Anthony Brooks. He was a little shifty player in that first half, Cole, that kind of got OCC a few buckets when they needed him.
Yeah, he was, and it's really just getting the ball in free space and making the defense, you know, think about what you're going to do, and he's been successful in doing that.
There's your senior, Christian Rossi, the only senior on the Mighty Oaks team so far. He got recognized before the game and got inside for his first points of the second half. OCC the other way responds. And this kind of feels like that track meet we saw at the beginning of the first half, was both teams really going out in transition, trying to create offensively. Franco drives and scores.
And you really don't want to give in to the track meet. If you can slow things down, you should try and really try to control the game.
That was the biggest thing, biggest takeaway really from both sides, was trying to slow things down offensively, because both these offenses are so potent. As that three ball comes up short from William Scanlon, ESF the other way. Emery, no, but the cleanup is there on aisle six by Nate McCarthy.
His offensive rebounding has been impeccable today, Nico, and it's these second chance points that we're going to look back on when the clock strikes zero, and you know, it's really going to play into the difference of the game.
6-point game here inside the JMA Wireless Dome, a little up and under. Seth Miles gets on the board here in the second half, and he's kind of been that X factor, especially as a somewhat bigger forward for OCC, Cole.
Yeah, and he's really a complete player all around. We saw it last game where he went 14-10. And he can really produce on both the offensive and defensive end.
So William Scanlon picks up the foul there for the Lasers. And that's going to send the Mighty Oaks to the free throw line. So we get another look at Patrick Emery. He's been producing, he produced double-digit points in the first half, and obviously the leading point scorer on this Mighty Oaks team. And he struggled a bit in the free throw line, I think would be his only downside in that first half, makes the first one here.
Yeah, and if he can keep getting to the basket and start sinking these free throws, it's going to be a long day for the Lasers, as he really made a statement in the first half, as you mentioned.
Yeah, after those first few minutes of the game where ESF was down by eight, he was the one that got him back in it. A made three and a couple of more baskets thereafter. Ended up knocking down another three before the end of the first half. Ball's loose on the floor, picked up by the Mighty Oaks. And ESF looking to create and transition once again. Little drive down the left lane, too short. Franco couldn't connect on it. And now it's OCC the other way. Matthews too strong, and that's been a problem for both sides, is finishing at the hoop. These teams play so fast, a very fast brand of basketball, that it comes down to finishing. And again, unsuccessful right there. Christian Rossi couldn't get it going. Boy, a lot of scrappiness going on in the last couple of minutes. And Cole, the question's going to be, really going forward in the second half, like we said at the top of the broadcast, who's going to slow things down defensively, because we've had that track meet in the last couple of minutes that we had at the beginning of the game.
I really think the slowing down is could be caused by just turnovers and free throws. You know, these two offenses are really so fast-paced, and I think you can add some inconsistency to their complete offenses. Thought that was a really nice pass, but it was stolen away by Emery.
Emery, a great takeaway for the Mighty Oaks. Rossi inside, feeds. McCarthy down low, and he punches it in. That's a timeout from OCC. Coach Holbert's going to talk things over for the Lasers. And the Mighty Oaks have come out strong here in this second half. Up by four at halftime, they've extended the lead to eight here with just about 5 minutes into the second half.
And the ESF taking a commanding 8-point lead, as we've mentioned and we talked about, if they get out to a sizable lead, how can they run away with the lead? How can they control the game after they get into the lead? You know, they were down 8 points early on in the first half, but they were able to execute offensively, tie the game back up, and they really put together a strong end of the first half, and that's why they're in the position that they're in right now.
Well, these Mighty Oaks students have come out, literally walked across the street. I mean, to be fair, the ESF campus is right near Syracuse University here, and they've shown out, taken up the majority of the first few rows here at the JMA Wireless Dome, and they've had an exciting time so far, and really a fun product to watch on the floor. But you mentioned ESF trying to contain that lead, and I think they've done a nice job of doing that so far. I mean, in your eyes, Cole, what's kind of the takeaway that you have for the Mighty Oaks to try and take care of the basketball going forward in the rest of this game?
I really think you got to keep the ball in the hands of Rossi and Emery. These are two guys that are very good fundamental players, and they're not going to do anything careless with the basketball with the game on the line.
Chamberlain drives the baseline and scores. He's able to get it up under the hoop and ended things with the deuce. All right, so OCC just down by six. And at any moment, you feel like they're going to make a push. It's going to have to start on the defensive end. And there's a great two-week takeaway right there. Miles the other way. Now Chamberlain feeds a three. Scanlon just off the front rim. Great poke away defensively. And Miles scoops it up and in. Boy, that all started with Anthony Brooks.
What we've sort of started to realize is really have to gain possession of the basketball after it hits the iron. We've seen a lot of takeaways soon after rebounds by both teams, and it offers up second chance points for the team that frankly missed the shot.
Yeah, if you watch Anthony Brooks, number three in blue, he is just active on his feet. As that one's good by Chamberlain. So now it's OCC getting out in transition. A 6-0 run for the Lasers, three straight buckets.
Chamberlain, a nice hop step to get to the block with a soft lane.
Franco uses his size and gets one to go inside. Again, both these teams matching up for the second time this season. OCC played ESF in their first game, and now they get them here to end the season. You know, it's like writing an article. It's like writing a story. You got to tie the ending with the beginning, right?
That's right.
Andrew Cox drives the baseline. That one goes out of bounds. It'll stay Mighty Oaks basketball. Of course, OCC 11-0
against ESF, dating back since 2011, and ESF so far giving itself a chance to change that dynamic today.
Yeah, when we talked to Coach Hulbert for Onondaga Community College, he told me that these games are going to be close no matter what, and these two teams are always going at it.
First one, OCC won by just 9 points. But the difference in that game was it was such a high-scoring affair. I mean, you look at the final score, 116-107. OCC beat ESF. And
yeah.
Today, I highly doubt we're going to get up to that number, but it just shows you that both these teams have improved defensively since the first game of the season.
And truly what they're capable of doing offensively on really any given night. I like Emery getting back to the free throw line within first 5 minutes here in the second half. He's really the difference. If they want to put this game away, him getting to the basket and finishing, an emphasis on finishing, is going to be the key.
Emery, a sophomore forward, he's going to shoot a couple at the line. The officials talking with both head coaches at the moment, trying to determine what the last determination of the foul was. Emery coming off a team-high 26 points. That was at Five Towns a couple of weeks back, February 9th. ESF ended up winning that game. That's been their most recent win, and they've just been 1-1 since then, coming off a loss against Villa Maria from Buffalo last Saturday.
Villa Maria was very impressive as they enter their conference tournament. Really had strong big men, and that was why ESF struggled, is they couldn't cover the man down low. Now they're playing a team that they match up perfectly with, and that's why we're starting to see such great success from them and keeping this game really close.
Well, not exactly sure what both sides are looking at here, as there's been a lot of discussion from both head coaches and the head official. But I want to ask you a little trivia question, Cole.
Sure.
I mentioned Five Towns. It's a school in Long Island, Dix Hills, New York. What celebrity from The Voice went to school there?
You're asking me a question
about...
One of the judges.
Ooh. If that narrows it down at all.
I was always a big American Idol guy, so...
Okay, all right.
I can't say I know.
Fair enough. Well, I don't know if he's actually a judge anymore. I haven't watched the show in a few years. But Adam Levine...
Okay.
...went to Five Towns Community College.
Right on.
Or college, I should say. And, yeah, that's where ESF played a couple weeks ago down there. They ventured down and came out with a 13-point win. But there you go. The more you know. Adam Levine...
That's right.
Five Towns College. So the next time someone asks you...
I'll keep that one in my back pocket.
Awesome. Nico. Well, we're still having a bit of a, I don't want to say review because they're not reviewing, but both coaches are trying to figure out with the official what the latest determination is. Not sure if it's based on a recent basket more than the foul, but we're going to shoot some free throws nonetheless. Patrick Emery shooting two from the charity stripe. This is the first. Emery, a 82% free throw shooter. He's been historically good this season, but he's missed a few from the line today.
And he's still in the double digits in points.
Yeah, he's really killed it. I mean, a couple of three-pointers, finishing inside for the most part. Just can't exactly knock him down from the free throw line. As that basket is good by Noah Armstrong. Another laser player that was a little quiet in the first half, despite coming off a team-high 23-point performance last game.
You can see why he was so successful last game. He really puts his head down, drives in strong when he wants to get to the basket.
Straightaway three is off, and another rebound for the Lasers. A chance to take the lead. All tied up, approaching the 13-minute mark to go here in the second half. Armstrong again picks up his dribble, has to dish it out. Here's a three for Matthews. Short. OCC hasn't had the lead since a little later on in the first half. ESF led by four at halftime. Went on a run to start the second half. OCC's crashed back in, but now it's the senior Christian Rossi driving inside, getting the and one.
really nice move by Rossi. And what is his final regular season game against his former college? If he can get going, it's going to be very tough for OCC to take a commanding lead here in the second half.
Rossi misses the three-point opportunity. You mentioned former team, and you know he played with OCC last season, but he was also a state champion with West Genesee in 2019. Ended up playing at Onondaga Community College, and now he played with the team last year. He's on ESF now, the only senior on this Mighty Oaks team, as Antonio Franco gets the score inside there on the last possession. OCC the other way. Jackson finishes inside, and we're going back and forth here inside the JMA Wireless Dome. 12 minutes to go in the second half. As ESF slows things down, Rossi controls. Near side three, Cox. He's got it. Andrew Cox makes a three-pointer, and ESF now trails by a rather tight game, 65-65. OCC the other way misses, and Cox keeps it in. Mighty Oaks out in transition again. Three, Franco. That one's short. Heat check there. Rossi finishes for the Oaks. Back and forth basketball. Anthony Brooks tries to create down the baseline. Foul's called. It's going to be charged to Nate McCarthy for ESF. So ESF, a five-point lead, 67-62. Approaching the midway mark through this second half as we bring on the athletic director for ESF, Dan Raymond. And Dan, happy to have you with us here on the broadcast. ESF looking good so far.
Wow, guys, great game, great game. I want to thank you guys, man. SU Broadcasting, ESF-TV, always do a fantastic job covering the games. Love it, love it.
Well, we thank you for that, and it's been an entertaining one so far
absolutely.
In this contest. And you look at both these teams real quick, and, you know, they play each other the very first game of the season, now the very last game of the season. How cool is it for these two teams, obviously a lot of them local from the Syracuse area, to play their game inside a very famous basketball arena and stadium?
It's perfect. It's perfect. It's just a great ending to a pretty positive season. And I think, the Dome, this is a piece of, landscape that just resonates around Syracuse, around our culture, around basketball for sure. Everybody knows that all these kids, oh, that are on these teams, probably come here, you know, as they were little kids who were watching SU hoops. So it's just great for them to have a chance to play, you know, to get down and really feel the court and see how maybe difficult it is to shoot in here at times.
It's definitely different from a small gymnasium. We were talking about that earlier with the free throws. It's like, you know, you have some guys that they're going to have a little bit of nerves just because the distance is farther back in the glass, and it changes up from time to time. Nico Horning, Cole Weintraub, joined by the ESF athletic director, Dan Raymond. And Dan, Cole and I were talking about earlier as well. Just 24 hours ago, Jim Boeheim was honored on this court for the first time since retiring after 47 years as SU's head coach. As Rossi finishes inside once again, Christian Rossi been very effective in the last few minutes. But
yeah, what a fantastic game that was yesterday.
It was.
It was really special, man. Very, very special. And to honor everybody the way they did, the whole staff here at the Dome, all the people behind the scenes, they do a fantastic job really making everybody feel welcome and be special.
And they put on so many, you know, just varying events, whether it's concerts, whether it's basketball games. You have the changeover crew from football to basketball to lacrosse, and now a chance for both of these teams to play here inside the Dome. You know, for ESF Athletics, we had Sean Dristel and Aubriana Brown on here at halftime from the national championship cross-country team. What is it like for the athletics to just come together and play inside an arena like this? But more importantly, all the teams culminating with each other and rooting on each other.
Oh, it's beautiful. It really is a sense of community, and it's great to have it done here. You know, to see a lot of student athletes come and root everybody on. And yeah, it was a very special season for our cross-country team, man. Those guys, those two individuals that you mentioned, are just really special student athletes. And really, it's an honor to have them at ESF for sure.
Definitely. That's awesome. As far as ESF athletics go, anything that you're trying to incorporate into the future years here, few years?
I think now what we're really trying to do is solidify everything we have. We want to really just try to continue to improve our facilities, trying to continue to improve just the better student-athlete experience. You know, eventually we would like to add, I really am a big lacrosse fan, I'd love to add some lacrosse. But, you know, I got to really be pragmatic and focus on what we can do right and do it better, you know. So we're kind of, that's kind of where we're at now. But, you know, I hand it to our student-athletes, you know, we're you know, at times we kind of got to do it a lot more difficult than a lot of other student-athlete programs in the SUNY system. But we do, and we manage, and these guys are just warriors, and they do an awesome job. So
that's great to hear.
Not to mention, man, the academics at ESF can be rigorous. So
right.
they really step it up on both sides of it, which is nice.
That's great to hear. I mean, I think it gets – maybe it does get enough recognition now, but, I mean, student-athlete, you have to be both. And I think that's just a very hard thing to do, first of all, no matter what sport you're playing.
Yep.
So here's Emery the other way. Oh, yeah. He rims in. ESF has been going on a 9-2 run, and they have a 10-point lead over the Lasers. Past the midway mark here inside the JMA Wireless Dome, the final game of this 2023-24 season. Jackson, or rather Matthews, misses inside, and ESF a chance to go up by even more, up by 10 right now.
Start to see Emery really taking control after a really strong ending to the first half. He's looking to bring that success into the second.
Rossi couldn't hit there, the only senior on this ESF team. And coach, you know, bringing it back into the basketball team, you have a guy like Christian Rossi who is the only senior on this team, a very young team going into the future. What do you expect from this team going on down the line these next couple of years?
I expect some great things. You know, we have some great recruits that are in the crowd here today, too. My coach, I can't speak highly enough of him. He just has such a positive energy to the whole team. So I definitely look forward to this team just continuing to improve. But, man, as you can see it here all day long, man, these guys are fighters. And that was really, even the games we've lost, we've been in. You know, and that's, you know, that's the thing that every time you just want to try to improve as a team, and these guys really just are full of it, full of that battle.
We were talking to Coach D'Antonio before the game, and that word you just mentioned, toughness, that's exactly what he described Christian Rossi to be. I mean, they brought him in from OCC last year, and he's just been a culture changer for you guys, you know, from the outside, but internally, having him be the only senior on this team, getting recognized before the game, what has he brought to your program?
He's just brought a high energy, a kind of grit, you know, just a really good grit player that's smart, you know, plus he's just, you know, funny and a kind person, you know, this is the kind of, you want to have both sides of it, you know, and he's, you know, smart, very, very smart, and I expect some great success for him later in life, for sure. But it's just great to watch him play, man, just because he plays with such heart. And all these guys do. Emery is the same. All of them. I really could name them all, man. It's beautiful to see the way we do it.
That's amazing. The steal there by Zachary Chamberlain. Feeds it ahead to Miles, and he lays it in. OCC trying to get back in this one. Just a six-point game. ESF up 74-68. Approaching the eight-minute mark to go here in the second half.
Oh.
OCC again, a little scrappy basketball here in the last few seconds. Miles again at the rim, dishes it to Chamberlain, and he scores. Just a four-point game, 74-70 ESF on top of OCC, and Rossi wants to slow things down.
Yeah,
just
we've
a little
had
bit.
Some close ones in here.
Yep, nope, for sure. And
we've had some overtimes, you know, on the foul line even. So,
and I mean, yeah. And both these teams, last couple of years, the game's been very close. Just a two-point game last year, and then even at the beginning of this year, a nine-point game. But, Dan, we want to thank you for coming on the broadcast here. Appreciate you, and good luck the rest of the season and the rest of the way with ESF Athletics.
Hey, thank you much, guys. Always a pleasure. Take care.
You as well. Dan Raymond, the athletic director for ESF, as Nate McCarthy gets one to go inside. Nico Horning, Cole Weintraub here inside the JMA Wireless Dome. ESF 76, OCC 70. That basketball knocked out of bounds. It's going to stay Lasers ball.
Starting to see the momentum swing a little bit in the favor of OCC, and I think that's because of
frankly, ESF is not protecting the basketball as well as they were at the end of the first half. They really need to, you know, get back to that. You know, keep the ball in the hands of Emery and Rossi, and they'll do the rest of the work.
McCarthy again. Oh, what a defensive play and takeaway from Anthony Brooks. Miles, a couple of steps inside, just short off the glass. You know, Anthony Brooks, one of those players, Cole, that he's really done it defensively. He's so active on his feet and did it with his hands there, created something offensively for OCC.
He's really a complete player, and I think going into next year, if his offensive efficiency improves, he could really become one of the best players in the conference.
Going back and forth here on the campus of Syracuse University. A little pull-up J off the back rim. Setton couldn't get it to go. Of course, ESF just to the left side of this basket across the street. Been here for over 100 years. Part of the State University of New York, and a basketball program that's on the rise, up by 10 over OCC, a team they've never beaten before, on the verge of doing so today.
And it's really cool that they've started a tradition for their final regular season, play host to another team in the JMA Wireless Dome. They've done so since 2018, and you know, starting that tradition, something to look forward to at the end of the season. Definitely what a program wants and desires.
Owen Salerno going to the free throw line for ESF, and they're in the bonus. So, Cole, that's a pretty big momentum boost for the Mighty Oaks from here on out.
Definitely, and we saw something very similar in the first half. OCC getting into really immediate foul trouble halfway through the half.
So if you're ESF, I mean, you're going to try and be driving to the hoop, really, on the bonus, try and draw some fouls, go to the free throw line. Is that what you do if you're Coach D'Antonio?
I really think so. You want to control the lead, slow the game down. You got to just get to the free throw line and really induce those fouls.
We'll see how ESF manages these last 6 minutes of the game. Again, trying to beat OCC for the first time ever. As a takeaway right there from Owen Salerno. Doing it defensively, had one block last time out, and gets the steal right there for the Mighty Oaks. Just taking their time, trying to run out as much clock as they can on each possession.
Yeah, and you can hear Emery, who's sitting down at court side, telling them to slow down, telling his guys to slow down because they've got a commanding lead.
Cox couldn't connect from downtown. Offensive rebound from McCarthy. Boy, how many times have we had an offensive rebound today?
It's truly remarkable, especially from Nate McCarthy.
Heffernan, he's got it. Just a 19% three-point shooter on this team, and he draws it defensively as well.
Wow. What an effort. When you can have guys like that coming off your bench, making an impact as soon as they step foot on the court, it really takes a lot of the dirty work away from your star players, and it's really been evident today.
Well, we know Rossi can produce. We know Emery is a very skilled basketball player, but you're right. It does come down to those bench players and those other guys that may not be in the spotlight as often. And Kieran Heffernan, a guy that just averages under 3 points a game this season, really producing on the offensive end in the last couple of minutes for ESF. This guy's been rather quiet today. Lamar Matthews, credit to ESF, but he finishes right there.
Yeah, I think it's Matthews' size that they're able to counter so well. And he really hasn't gotten going like he did really so well in that first outing.
And even the first few minutes of this game, he was really active offensively, but ESF has done a really nice job of quieting him down ever since. Cox again, couldn't do it.
And to your point, it was really since that missed dunk attempt early in the first half for Matthews. He hasn't really gotten going since then.
OCC just having a bit of trouble finishing at the hoop. It's been a kind of nagging factor for them in this game.
And this is where protecting the basketball becomes more than important for a team that struggled with it all season long.
Exactly. The last thing you want to do is give it away here in these last few minutes. Patrick Emery draws the foul down low, and he'll be heading back to the free throw line.
Drawing these fouls in a 10-plus digit lead, like, they become so important because, like I said, it not only slows the game down, but you're able to tack on extra points.
Emery knocks down the first. Nico Horning alongside Cole Weintraub here inside the JMA Wireless Dome. ESF on top of OCC, 84-72. Make that 85 as Emery goes 2-for-2 from the free throw line. The Mighty Oaks in great position to try and close this thing out for their first ever win against OCC. Chamberlain flips it up and in. The second leading scorer on the Lasers. ESF trying to get out of the half court there, and I think that's going to be important for OCC the rest of the way, trying to apply some full court pressure.
Definitely.
Rossi tripped up inside that orange paint. And with ESF being in the bonus, it's going to result in another couple of free throws.
Looks like they just got into the double bonus with the 10th personal foul on OCC. Very similar to the first half. Just getting free buckets from the line.
And we know ESF can make three-pointers. I mean, they're a good three-point shooting team. They shot 30% at Five Towns in the win a couple of weeks ago, and we talked about it at the top of the broadcast was they're going to have to get going by driving to the hoop. That's going to be the difference maker today because too much this season they've settled from the three-point line, and it hasn't turned to be in their favor.
And they were really able to, you know, get to the basket, and they've really started to hit these free throws, which become so important in the later stages of the game.
We've got a timeout here as ESF is up 13 over OCC here at the Dome. A lot of these fans have showed out today, especially a lot of ESF students sitting here on both baselines. As you look at the Lasers huddle there, and head coach Joel Hobart trying to wrap his squad together here in the last 3 minutes of the season. Coach D'Antonio doing the same thing on ESF side.
Yeah, and if you're Hobart and his squad, you really just have to start firing from behind the arc. Start to try to gain some momentum back and see what you can get really from shooting around the perimeter. It's the only way to get back into a 13-point game with just 3 minutes to go.
Cole, you talk about a guy like Lamar Matthews, and you know, we mentioned a couple minutes ago, he's been quiet today, but he made 5 of 8 from three-point land last game. I mean, you'd think he's the one that's going to have to get going here in the last few minutes for this team to have any shot down the stretch. So here we go, 3 minutes to go. ESF on the verge of its first ever win against OCC. And another defensive stop there. Good defense inside by Christian Rossi. The only senior on this Mighty Oaks team. Just a young squad that, if they hold on, this would be a very, very impressive win this season.
You start to see the Lasers becoming much more aggressive defensively, but when you're already in foul trouble, it really takes a lot of that away from you, and you can't be as aggressive on defense and really starting to force those turnovers. It's just ending up resulting in more ESF free throws.
The last game of the season from both sides. No postseason for ESF. They've lost the last 3 of 4, but looking to get another win here today. It'd be a big one. Up 15 over OCC in the final 3 minutes. Matthews rattles off both rims. The putback, no. And ESF again, another rebound. I mean, both these teams, they don't have the size. But you see the activeness in the paint from the Mighty Oaks today, and I think that's been just a huge difference maker.
And they realized very early that it wasn't really starting to fall from behind the arc, and they really had to, you know, turn to getting inside and making plays that way. And, you know, it opened up some three-pointers along the way, and they've really started to sink some shots behind the arc too.
There's a poke away from ESF. Antonio Franco taking it full court, and he lays it in. Cole, that might have been the cherry on top in this game here inside the dome.
You are most likely correct, as see Miles kicking the ball on the inbound. I can't say I've ever seen one of those before.
I mean, these OCC players, rightfully so, they're frustrated. They're just trying anything right now. Nothing is really getting to go at the rim, and just a tough day overall from the Lasers. But credit to the Mighty Oaks defense, really showing up today. And Coach D'Antonio mentioned at the beginning of the game, if they can hold these guys to, you know, under 100 points, obviously that would be huge, and they've really done so today.
And I think the number that he set was 85, and it's looking pretty good right now. Just a minute and 20 to play.
ESF 93, OCC 76. And the Mighty Oaks are just going to take these last couple of minutes and soak it all in. And, you know, despite some abnormal catastrophe, ESF is going to take its first ever win against OCC.
As you see Rossi and Coach D'Antonio bringing it in, as this will be his final seconds on a collegiate basketball court. Strong career from the Mighty Oaks guard, and a really cool moment for him, and really a great moment for their program as they put this thing away.
Yeah, huge win for ESF. That was kind of the question we asked there in the first few minutes of the second half, would be how would they close things out, and they have really executed that and done so today. Emerson Johnson on the floor, so is Owen Salerno.
Azir Sanders.
Yep. You have it, Therena.
OCC.
You have it, Therena. Step back three. Just wide. And how about that? A fitting win for ESF. You get a couple of guys that don't play as much on the floor, and you can't call it any better. Everyone gets a little piece of the cake here inside the JMA Dome.
Why not?
You have it, Therena. Kicking it outside. Heffernan. Too strong on the three-pointer. He knocked out a big three earlier when he had that three-pointer, and the defensive stop as well on the other end. Two straight possessions. Whistle's blown inside with just over 10 seconds to go here inside the JMA Wireless Dome. ESF up by 17. And the Mighty Oaks are going to defeat the Lasers for the first time this season. Had some great guests on the broadcast today. We had Dan Raymond, the athletic director for ESF. And, of course, ESF cross country won another national championship this year. Sean Dristel from the men's side, Aubriana Brown from the women's side, brought them on the show. And with that, ESF's going to dribble it out. And the Mighty Oaks have dropped some poison oak on OCC. 93-77. The Mighty Oaks have beaten the Lasers for the first time in program history. That 0-11 streak has come to an end.
You know, there's a saying that you're due, and the Mighty Oaks were certainly due, and they came out today and, you know, got the ball in the hands of their playmakers, and they had one job, and it was to get to the basket. They got OCC in foul trouble, and, you know, truly the difference maker was just the offensive rebounds and just the pure effort that ESF was going to put it all on the line in their final game of the season here in the JMA Wireless Dome.
Really impressive win from the Mighty Oaks. Coach D'Antonio talking in the huddle. So ESF's going to end the season at 6-13. But a really just impressive win overall. I think on both ends of the floor, Cole, that this Mighty Oaks team can carry into the offseason.
Yeah, it was a complete W. And, you know, as Dan Raymond mentioned, there were some recruits in the stands, and they're able to see what this program is like and what is in the cards if they join a program like this who has an opportunity to play in such a great environment. And, you know, defensively today, we talked about how they struggled all season long. That was not the case today. They were going to put everything on the line, like I mentioned, and they were able to do so, and it was really key to their success today, protecting the basketball and playing defense.
Yeah, big win today for ESF to round out the season. Once again, 93-77, your final score as we get a look at our final stats here. The one thing that sticks out to me, Cole, the rebounds. ESF had 31 at the end of the first half. OCC had, I might have gotten my numbers mixed up, but it was a three-rebound differential at halftime. Look at the differential now, 18 rebounds. ESF has more than OCC, and that was the biggest factor in this game.
You take a look at those second chance points. You talk about that rebound differential. It comes down to those offensive rebounds because they tallied up. Obviously, you're going to get defensive rebounds naturally with shot misses, but they were able to grab their own rebounds and go back up with it, and they did it successfully today.
A huge win for ESF to round out the 2023-24 season. A big win over the Lasers, and ESF is going to have a pretty hot offseason to bring into next year, and I think everyone's excited to see what the future holds for this ESF basketball team. It's our final broadcast of the 2023-24 basketball season. The names on the screen made our basketball coverage possible. Our thanks to the athletic departments at Onondaga and ESF for their assistance throughout the season. And of course, the great people here at the JMA Wireless Dome doesn't go unnoticed. And our colleagues at WSTM-TV in Syracuse for their generous production support. On behalf of our outstanding production crew and my broadcast partner, Cole Weintraub, I'm Nico Horning. ESF wins 93-77. For OCC. College Basketball on ESFTV is a production of ESFTV in association with CNY Stream. Once again, 93-77 ESF over Onondaga. Your final score, Nico Horning saying goodnight from Syracuse.